Hi everyone. Okay, Samsung have dropped an update for the Galaxy S4, and this one's a bit of a doozy. Basically, they've added some features, they've cleaned up the interface a little bit. As you can see up at the top here in the notification shade, there's now a kind of translucent area, this transparency, and it looks kind of fetching and all, gives a bit of a depth of field effect. But also, the interface is incredibly quick. Things have tightened up quite a bit. A lot of the interface lag seems to have disappeared completely, which is really nice to see. We'll have to wait and see how that works out over time, but it's promising at the moment. Now, also of interest is they seem to be getting a bit more control over the memory usage as well. Obviously, background tasks will kick back in now and start filling up memory again, but it's good to see that overall they are making a few improvements here on how much memory the device is using. Now, one of the other really interesting features, let me come into settings, is if we come into more in the application manager, we now have, let me just pick something suitable, let's go with that one. We now have a move to SD card option available in here. Now, I'm having a few problems getting it working, but it is promising that we do have that there. What I found is some apps can be moved to the SD, others can't, but in some cases I'm finding that I can't actually move them to the SD card at all. Let me just see if I can find one that I had earlier on. So this one will supposedly move to the SD card. There we go, it's actually done it this time, fantastic. Although I'm not completely sure why, it's only some applications that do seem to be able to move to the SD, others not so much. But the option is there, we can now free up a little bit of space on our internal storage. Although it should be noted that it doesn't appear from other people on forums that have been testing this that it moves all of the game data across. Some of it goes across, some of it doesn't. Specifically, it tends to be the smaller apps that will move all of their data, but if it's got a separate large download, you know, things like Grand Theft Auto, you're not going to find the game data actually carried across. Check out a video I've made for Folder Mount if you want to be able to move all of your data across onto your SD. Also of interest is the icon on the About device has changed, whether that's because this is a German build or whether that's going to be permanent, not completely sure. But certainly there is a lot of really, really interesting stuff going on here. The whole fact that the smartphone has reduced the lag considerably with this update, the general look and feel, everything is starting to feel so much better and tighter for the Galaxy S4. Who knows, Samsung might be able to fix this thing with software. Now, the next thing I want to take a look at is the reported HDR video functionality. Now, we'll just have a quick look at what setting options we have in here for video. Not seeing anything particular in there. Okay, let's switch the video on and see if we get any new options. I've decided that I'm in night mode. Yeah, you see, I'm not really seeing any additional options there. Certainly no HDR video, but let's stop that and have another look in settings. Maybe we've missed something. I don't see anything specifically there. Perhaps this HDR video is something that is on by default. Let's try a £5 note, shall we? See what we get. Well, I think it's pretty difficult to tell at this point, but you know, we'll play around with the HDR video and see whether that is actually a true feature or whether it's just some rumored thing at this point. But to me, at least, unless it's somewhere hiding away in here, rich tone HDR. Not seeing anything particularly. Let's pop it on HDR mode, rich tone, and see whether that does anything for video as well. I can't really see. I mean, if there is anything going on there, it's certainly not giving me any indication on the screen, unfortunately. But if you're interested in this update and you can't wait for Samsung to push it locally to your regions, you can go and download this update off XDA developers. There's a forum thread. I will pop it in the description. All you need to do is download the update, use Odin, which is a flashing tool, pop your device into download mode, flash the update. Because it's an official update from Samsung, it won't void your warranty, it won't increase any of the counters that Samsung have put on there to indicate whether you've rooted your phone and voided your warranty or anything like that. So it's perfectly safe to install. Just bear in mind though, you will get German applications as this is a German build. But you know, by and large, that's not too bad of a problem, or too much of a problem. Like I say, Samsung have done a cracking job at getting this update out, and it certainly feels like the S4 is starting to find its feet a little bit. No longer the quite such a frustrating mess that it was before.